G'day folks, TECHMANPAT here. The Dirt Report is coming back in full force later this month when I'm back from New York. For now, we get these mini versions and today's topic is rather spicy, so stay tuned and welcome. More than 30,000 customers have disconnected from the NBN last year. In fact, it is the first year that the NBN has lost customers. So let's talk about potential reasons and what we can expect going forward from the NBN. Make sure to like and subscribe to support us to be notified of future videos. So let's get started by rolling the intro. The number was heard loud and clear at a press conference with RPM. He was asked, 30,000 NBN customers were disconnected last year. Is it becoming unaffordable for households that are already struggling? To which he replied,
what we've had to deal with the National Broadband Network is the fact that the former government turned what was a fibre-based 21st century infrastructure project into a, you know, tin pot operation with copper wire replacing fibre.
I'll cut that there as he then goes into political grandstanding and that's not something we need for this video. But to add context, the previous government believed copper was better than fibre, which we knew a decade ago not to be true. So, what's going on with the disconnections? If you have been following this channel, we've covered NBN price increases. Go have a watch of those videos. They've gone up significantly. And since NBN executives need bonuses to put food on their holiday home tables, looking at the current prices, we can see that after NBN Co. increased the wholesale price, the average cost to the consumer, you and I, went up by about 10% on the lowest plans. That's right, the cheapest plans got the increase, but the higher plans did not. In fact, they got a discount. NBN thought by increasing the price of the lower plans, it'll force people to upgrade because it's so close to that next step, which is 100 down, 20 up, if you're on the 50 down plan. Because that 50 down plan is the most popular one in Australia, mainly due to price, but also since a lot of properties can't even get higher than 50 megabits a second, that also forces them into some sort of glass ceiling where they can't really upgrade anyway. So price increase is a little bit frustrating because the service doesn't change. But generally, a price increase doesn't turn current customers away from the service that they're using. They may end up connecting to another RSP, for example, moving from TPG to Aussie Broadband for a $5 savings because they're offering something better for the first 6 months. But this is not the case here. It was 30,000 hard disconnects from the NBN service. So these people went to an alternative service or none at all. With the current cost of living increases over the last 2 years, job growth slowdowns, you can imagine that many of these people needed to cut costs. I believe a large number of these people dropped their services altogether in favor of their existing mobile services that they may have already been using as a home internet solution and may not need the power that an NBN connection provides. Now, with phone internet, you can still access all the necessary life services and access social media. And many phone plans have plenty of data and you can watch Netflix and KO and whatever you want to do. It's all there. You can then hotspot it to your laptop. But I also would like to add, it's generally a lot harder to drop a phone plan due to the device contract, unlike the NBN, which is generally also month to month and quick and easy to just call up and say, I don't want it anymore. The next group, a much larger portion, I believe, would have moved onto mobile services such as 5G or 4G, which offers better or same performance as the NBN at similar prices that they would have had before the increase. A financial choice, but also potentially a better service. To specify, I think 5G has been taking customers off the NBN, not just due to cost, but also better performance. Then I think it's those who moved over to Starlink. Back in February 2023, NBN Co. labeled the exodus to Starlink modest, and I think they may have been skirting the subject a little bit. It was modest back then, but I think today it is a big red flag. I think Starlink has taken more NBN customers than NBN has let on. The fact that Starlink became profitable roughly 2 years after they entered the Australian market is saying something. Even though Starlink is more expensive, it's better performance and better service in places where NBN just can't reach with copper or fiber and satellite services are terrible and low speeds. You see, many users are on obsolete copper technology that is costing an arm and a leg, and they just don't see the value. Fixed wireless is a dog and pony show. Fiber upgrades are slow and require higher paying plans to even receive. In combination with economic and technological advances, the NBN is not competitive anymore. The NBN was built to provide a competitive landscape for broadband while providing low-cost access, hopefully to fast internet across Australia. And as of today, the NBN has strayed even further away from that initial decree, and these customers disconnecting is really showing. The cheapest NBN plan right now is $49 at Tangerine per month for 25 megabits per second down. This plan is very rare, as many ISPs have dropped the 25 megabits down plan altogether. In fact, there used to be a 12 down, 1 up plan that just doesn't exist anymore. It literally costs more to deliver than the ISP charges. So, a decade ago, almost $30 billion was thrown at the NBN, who bought enough copper to encircle the planet a few times. They promised 100 down and 40 up to every person in Australia. Then they reduced it to 100 down and 20 up. Prices have steadily risen, and the lowest access plans have been dropped. Fiber upgrades are too slow, and it doesn't really fix the low-cost issue in the first place. So, what's next? Well, 2024 is here. It'll bring more disconnections to the NBN, that's for damn sure. Starlink is only getting better. They're testing 20 millisecond latency. They're also testing mobile phones straight to satellite services. That could turn the telco world upside down. 5G coverage is becoming less spotty. The NBN may end up only serving customers who demand high-speed internet at home or in their business. Fiber upgrades will end up at homes that don't really want it or need it or then can afford it. So what about solutions, ideas? There are a couple of things that I think need to change. First of all, there may need to be a shakeup of management. Cost reduction should come from the top. So let's start there. They should bolster the fiber upgrades, double down and do it right, then simplify the CVC costing so ISPs are inclined to offer a service rather than a specific plan with a higher margin. That's important. You have to incentivize them to just offer services, not just the highest paying one. This should in turn reopen low tier plans to smaller ISPs, bridging the competitive landscape between Telstra, TPG and everyone else. But let me know what you guys think. Have you been one of the people who completely disconnected the NBN? Where did you go? What are you doing now? Is it the cost of living? Friends, thank you very much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I'll catch you all in another video. Bye.